It's blueberry harvest time at Carter Farms in White Lake in Bladen County. Pickers will make several passes through the fields over a couple of weeks' time. That's because not all the berries on a bush ripen at the same time.
Everything has to do their part to make it all, to get it where it is today. You know, for us to be here and be picking, there are so many steps that have to take place for us to get here.
And it all starts with the honeybee, which must visit and pollinate every bloom on every blueberry bush before the flower will produce a berry. In fact, for a blueberry to reach normal size, honeybees need to visit each blossom about a half dozen times.
Okay, so we put just a little bit of smoke on the outside and then right on the top, just to let them know that we're coming inside.
Trouble is, honeybee colonies throughout the world are in decline. The U.S. Department of Agriculture reports over the past 8 years, almost 30% of honeybee colonies maintained by beekeepers die each winter. And that shortage of bees puts the food supply at risk, because bees pollinate not only blueberries, but most fruits and vegetables, as well as cotton and coffee and many other farm products. In fact, bees are credited with pollinating one out of every three bites of food we eat.
They often build some wax on the top here.
For Ralph Carter, the decline of the wild honeybee means hiring beekeepers to bring in colonies of bees to pollinate his blueberry crop.
To make sure that we have adequate amount of bees, we look to 2.5 to 3 hives per acre so that bloom can be visited 6 times. Yes, sir, that's correct.
I think everyone has to be worried about the health of the honeybee. Clearly there's numbers that indicate that the decline of the honeybee is increasing in some areas or stable at best. There's other areas where it's increasing. But because the honeybee is so vital to agriculture, we have to make sure we're protecting the health of it. And so by looking at all of these factors together and how they're relating, that's how we're going to achieve some of the sustainable solutions to ensure that we still have honeybees to pollinate the crops.
Now this colony probably has about 30,000 bees. We just started it in April, so this is a very new colony, but the queen is doing very well.
This bee colony is located at Bayer Crop Science's new North American Bee Care Center in Research Triangle Park. The bees in this hive will fly up to 10 miles away in search of food. Researchers at the center are monitoring the health of the bees in the hive, as well as studying what types of microbes bees carry in and on them that can help protect them. It's one of several research projects at the center looking at the many issues threatening bee colonies. Those threats include parasites, diseases, extreme weather, a lack of food sources, and the effects of chemicals, including insecticides.
So these are the kind of sentinel bee hive samples that we get. They come to us frozen, and then we have to sort them into the different kinds of bees to determine both what kinds of bees are dying normally, and we can also spot some things that are obvious, like varroa mite sticks out, and also we can look for one viral presence, which is the deformed wing virus.
Jacob Dooms is a graduate student at NC State. He's working with farmers around the country on what are called sentinel hives. Farmers collect their dead bees and send them to the Bee Care Center for study.
So we sort them into their components, deformed wing, normal wing.
While honeybees only live for about 30 days, an entire colony can collapse in a few weeks. The Sentinel Colony Project can alert farmers to potential problems. One of the biggest threats to bees comes from the varroa mite. To put in perspective, on a person, that is how big the mite would be. Now, think of that if you're a bee. The mite attaches to the back of the bee. It sucks the blood out of the bee and injects diseases into the bees. Researchers are trying to figure out how to control the varroa mite without killing the bees. While the varroa mite might be the biggest natural threat to honeybees, it's the possible effect of pesticides on bee colonies that creates the most controversy. Each side in the debate wields scientific studies as evidence that chemicals do or do not harm honeybees.
Pesticides can be a stress factor. Pesticides, not just what farmers are using to control crop pests, but also the pesticides that beekeepers themselves supply to control pests like varroa mites. There's another pest called the small hive beetle that sometimes they apply insecticides inside the hive to control. So that's a potential concern.
Researchers say it is clear that saving the honeybee will take a comprehensive approach. Scientists at the Bee Care Center want to understand just what that approach must be.
What we need to do in agriculture is we need to get as much food per acre as we can, so we don't have to put as many acres into cropland. And that allows us to set aside more acres for nature. And to do that, we need good agricultural crop protection tools. We need pollination services. And honeybees are the species that are the most adaptable for providing those services.
The good news on Ralph Carter's blueberry farm is that it appears honeybees are making a comeback. He says he's seeing more wild bees this year, but...
And I'm afraid that the population really does not understand the full effects of the bees, of how much that they really touch our lives and stuff, you know.